based on decadence and hedonism of love and desire and sex, which also which is the very opulent feelings. Then you also have that ache of trying to ache when you're wanting something, you're sort of coveting something. So sort of wanton girls. We try to make them not romantic but beautiful creatures. And they just were like sort of creatures of the night, that they sort of survive in the night, which they wanted to leave little shadows under the eyes, but actually I've taken them out because I think that'll just look as if I'm not covering up the shadows. But we just want them to look just like creatures of desire, or that they're designed, they're loving, and whenever there's a love, there's always comes like sort of an ache. And with the clothes, it's very opulent clothes, but then you'll have parts that are totally deconstructive, but then you'll have this richness of gold embroider, of this amazing, beautiful leather harnesses and jackets. So this sort of sex desire, aching for something that you love, and it's like a hunger.
And what are we doing on the eyes today?
So on the hand, haven't even started. So on the eyes, we're just bringing out the natural hues of tones. And I wanted it sort of like a moonlight coming over the girls. But then again, I wanted to have that the contrast between the opulence of the clothes and then also the dishevelled, broken up. So it sort of wanted to be like moonlight, but maybe also some sort of lampshade down some, not some alleyway, but sort of like a dark street.
What products are you using?
I'm mainly using. And there's a lot about the base. I'm using these the MAC Studio Sculpt foundations, which I just love. They instantly just give this sort of glowing skin. And then around the eyes, I'm sort of mashing up. I think there's like eight of the MAC cream bases. The darkest one is Root, and the lightest one being Shell and Hush. Fauntastic. And just sort of, we haven't even curled the, not curling the eyelashes, not using mascara. The darker colour above the lash line, and then with highlights sort of in the inner corner of the eyes and the outer, so on the forehead as well. So they're sort of, it's like they're sort of chasing something. So it's like the light is pulling them towards something, whether it's love or whether it's sex or desire that they're chasing.
And
so that's why there's
the
highlights.
So you keep, how are you doing the lips?
Lips, taking off the colour with the lip arrays, and then I'm putting a sheer colour which is called Syrup, which just, it's a little plummy colour, which just to give the lips sensuous lips. I didn't want to totally raise them and make them sort of too alien-like. The girls still had to be sensuous, which again on the cheeks were doing a little, a sort of, it's like a bruised colour, but not that these girls have been, you know, bruised, but it's just sort of the ache that you get with love, wants to reflect it in the cheeks, that it's not a sort of a pink flush of health and summer, but it's sort of a flush that's from desire and the chase. That's what I've used in Brit Wit, which is...
It's quite kind of like erotic.
Yeah, very, yeah, erotic and sensuous. And sex and desire is that sort of the innate feeling that people have. And so we wanted to keep them as sort of creatures, carnal. That's why they're not supposed to look as if they're wearing makeup, but they're just these innate characters searching.